All right, on today's episode, we're going to be checking out some famous cases of music plagiarism.
No. Terrible.
And we'll be deciding if we think it's legit.
Well, that's what we'll be doing.
So, a lot of these people are ripping off other people. I mean, it seems to be a thing.
I guess that's
since the beginning of time, right? But I feel like I'm hearing it more and more.
Different degrees of influence.
We're going to check out some famous ones and see if we think that they did it. Oasis made a song called Shaker Maker.
Shake Maker.
And it's supposed to be based on that I'd Like to Teach the World to Sing by the New Seeker. Let's listen to it. I know what part they're talking about.
Like
exactly.
To teach the world.
Yeah. Imperfect time. Mm-hmm. It's like he's definitely taking it. He even starts it off with "I'd like to," is the first phrase. He starts with the same exact first three words. Right. And it does sound like he's taken definitely a chunk of it, but it's not exactly.
Enough to be the...
Well, let's listen to the other one. Let's listen to the original.
It could have ripped like a quarter of it, you know?
There's definitely like a little overlap there, but I don't think it's
sometimes
the same.
Sometimes there's only so many chords that are, you know, there's gonna be common progressions and common like melodies that kind of go with those chords that seem like intuitive to your mind, right?
Yeah, I'm gonna say no.
I don't think so.
I can see the argument in the same words that I'd like to.
That's what I was saying about the last one, like. It's a matter of how much it envelopes.
It seems to be slightly. It's like influence.
He changes the back end of that. So
I think I'm gonna go with it's not a plagiarism.
Yeah, I don't know. But it was a ruling.
I don't know if that one actually went to court, but
does it tell us the ruling?
Yeah, it doesn't really say. Oh, it says the out-of-pocket costs of this unofficial songwriting tutorial $500,000.
And like you said, he. Couldn't even be bothered to drop the "I'd like to" from the two lines.
Right.
So, oh, okay.
Don't know.
All right, well.
I think that was, I don't know. All right, so.
Similar enough.
So this one is a real famous one. This is the Beach Boys. Surfing USA is a ripoff of Chuck Berry's Sweet Little 16.
Well, we all know Surfing USA, so let's see what Chuck Berry. All
right.
Surfing USA. Yeah, fuck yeah, man. Dude, I thought this was the same song.
It's like exactly the same, right? Wow.
Yes, yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's
wow.
They probably even had to, like...
Yeah, I don't even need to hear anymore, man. Yeah. That's like, that's as bad as it gets right there.
Yeah,
wow.
I guess at least they changed the lyrics, right?
But I hope the judge ruled in favor of...
There's no arguing here. Surfing USA is the same song.
Yeah.
All right. But the Beach Boys aren't the only ones to blame. Too many artists ripped them off over the years, like Johnny B. Goode. Ain't That Just a Woman? At least the Beach Boys fessed up, giving him song credits.
All right, good.
Well, they gave him song credits. So how about that, huh? Didn't even, no.
All right, so this one is a famous one. This is John Fogerty. And he got sued by Creedence Clearwater.
This dude was in Creedence Clearwater,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, so his old band sued him when he went solo and put out a song solo. Okay. So they're saying that this his new solo song sounds like Run Through the Jungle. So we all know what Run Through the Jungle is. We'll listen really? A little bit. So, this is John Fogerty, The Old Man Down the Road. He take a thunder from the mountain. He take a lightning from the sky. He bring a strong man to his begging knee. He make a younger mama cry. Oh, different so far. Yeah, that doesn't sound anything
like I know what they're talking about. That down, down,
down, down. There's a little bit something to the cadence of how he's singing, but it's, not saying, it's the same guy who wrote the same song, so of course...
He's going to have a lot of
It's just a weird situation, and, yeah. I know that he had to go into court and he actually testified and played in front of the judge and demonstrated how they were different compositions, and that ended up being the deciding factor. So I'm going to go with the judge and say... You can't steal from yourself. And who cares about his old bandmates, dude? The talent.
Talent's king. Yeah, that guy's probably the thing that was keeping them afloat.
Right.
Yeah.
All right, so here's another famous one. So
Ghostbusters theme song. Don't tell me.
Ghostbusters theme song.
Don't tell me it was Ray Parker Jr. was stealing. That was his meal ticket, man.
So did he steal that from... Huey Lewis in the News, I Want a New Drug. So that's the question mark.
Something dumb. Kinda, right?
It's something good. Yeah.
And it don't look good.
Totally.
Who are you gonna call?
Peter Gabriel! Ooh. That's bad. So they're saying that they settled out of court on this, but then Huey Lewis did a Behind the Music and talked all this shit about Ray Parker Behind the Music, and then Ray Parker was like, "Oh, you can't be talking that shit."
They
I don't know, they called him out, and I don't know, something happened.
Oh,
but
wow.
That's pretty bad.
Yeah, that's pretty.
I mean, dude, I don't know if it's like exact, but that's pretty bad.
That's close enough, man. I could definitely see an out of court settlement for that.
Right. This one is Coldplay.
Oh, I remember this one.
The Viva La Vida. And then they got sued by Jay. So, Joe Satriani, If I Could Fly. The world. Right.
All right, so that's Coldplay's terrible
record. So, Joe Satriani sued them over this.
Same melody.
Sounds pretty similar.
Same hook.
Yeah. That's pretty bad.
I mean, they changed the ending to kind of mask it, and I think that's probably typical what you'll see in plagiarism, you know, is they'll get inspired by a certain kind of direction or groove or sound or kind of hook. And then they'll just mask the scent by changing it a little bit. And that, you know,
that's what
Coldplay definitely...
Yeah, what's his name? Rod Stewart, when he had that, "If you want my body," that was taken from this, I don't know, I think it was like a Brazilian musician, but it was just an instrumental. It was like... And it was just basically that instrumental of that vocal line, and then he took it.
Yeah, well.
So I say, dude, Coldplay straight up.
Yeah, that was ripping, dude.
I don't imagine that Coldplay would be listening to Joe Satriani, though. Isn't that kind of weird?
Maybe somebody could have heard something way back when, or maybe in an elevator, for all that matter, and they're like, "Dude, that sounds good. I'm gonna, you know, go with that."
All right, so this is a Radiohead "Creep."
Oh, they stole some shit?
is a ripoff of The Hollies, The Air That I Breathe. So this is a lawsuit that went through it, and
everyone knows Radiohead Creep, I would say. At least most of the people are probably going to turn into anything that we have to say. So
we can
just go straight to The Hollies.
I think they had to pay him something. Let's check it out. I think he did it.
Totally.
It's pretty good.
Even the bass. Say Plagian.
Yeah, that's Plagian for sure.
Plagian.
Damn, dude, Radiohead's Plagian too.
That's cheap, man. And you get in with your hit singles, and it's almost like, well, that gets you on the map, so you got enough money to shut somebody else
up. That's what, like, Vanilla Ice did, where he was just like, oh, put it out, it'll be a hit, and then we'll just pay lawyers to make
it. So even if you have to pay 90%, you're now on the map with your 10%, and you get to make another piece of shit song, and people will still be like, dude, that's the guy that made the, you know, the big hit.
For sure.
Ooh, Baby, I Love Your Way, or the New Order cover by Orgy, or, you know, something that somebody's bread and butter, but it was a cover, and that's what got them the map.
No doubt. Mm-hmm. All right, well, if you like this episode, give us a like, give us a subscribe, and we'll see you again next time.